Dear students, welcome back for the today's new online topic for the discussion. The name of the topic is the human reproductive system. So in last lecture we have discussed what is endocrine system, what are the different hormones which are responsible for the growth and metabolism of the human body. Here we are discussing the new topic which is related with the sexual reproductions and the generation of new genetical body that contains human organs or gametes. So the topic name is reproductive system. Myself, Mr. Abhijit Ankush Khatre, working as a lecturer in KCDS Krishna College of Pharmacy, Karad. So let us discuss what are the different learning outcomes for the today's topic. Number one, students or learner will be able to identify the organs of the male and female reproductive system according to the sexual presentation. It differs from the organs, that is the male and female organs. According to that, students should identify the organs present in the both systems. Second, they understand the functions of the organs which is present in the male and female reproductive system. For male containing testes and the female containing the ovaries. So what is the function of these two, or what is the physiology of these two reproductive organs? Then third one is to explain the menstrual cycle which is present in the female. And fourth one, discuss the what are the changes occurring during the puberty or at the age of the puberty in male and female. So these are the four different learning outcomes. Now let us discuss what is reproduction. Reproduction means the transfer of genetic material from one generation to another for the maintenance, the continuation of the species. But another definition which is in front of you is transfer of offspring or the gametes and the formation of new living organism is called, or that process is known as the reproduction. So now what do you mean by gonads? Gonads means the primary sex hormones. It is also called as essential sex hormones or sex organs, known as ovaries for female and testes for the male. Now what is spermatogenesis? The formation of sperm from the germ cells of the testes is called the spermatogenesis, whereas oogenesis means the formation of ovum from the ovaries. So these are the different terminologies which are useful for the exam point of view. You should write in your notebook for the detailed explanation. Exam of the reproduction, spermatogenesis and oogenesis बऱ्याच वेळा विचारलेली आहे MSBT च्या एग्जाम मध्ये. सो यू शुड राइट ऑल दिस डेफिनेशन्स इन युअर नोटबुक. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट सिस्टम्स ऑफ द ह्यूमन बॉडी. देयर आर द टू डिफरेंट सिस्टम. नंबर वन इज द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम एंड सेकंड वन इज द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट ऑर्गन्स ऑफ द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम, वेयर एज द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम containing external genital organs and internal genital organs. Now let us discuss what are the different parts present in the male reproductive system, starting from the two testes, then two epididymis, it is also called as acrotome, then two different ducts, it is also called as vas deferens. So this is the diagram of the male reproductive system. Two spermatic ducts and seminal vesicles, two ejaculatory ducts, prostate glands, penis and urethra. So these all parts which is present in the male reproductive system, and this is the diagram in front of you. You should pause this video and write in your notebook the explanation and the diagram of this reproductive system. Now the next, what is the structure of sperm? The structure of sperm is the living motile gametes containing the head, neck, body and tail, which is formed by the process of spermatogenesis. So this is the structure of sperm. Now next, what is semen or seminal fluid? Exam madhe vicharlela ahe. This is the thick whitish fluid which is released by the urethra or ejaculated from the urethra during the sexual stimulation, having a slightly alkaline and pH is about 7.4. Now what is the composition? These are the different parts of the composition of the semen containing spermatogenesis, and some different secretions occurs in the different glands which is present in the male reproductive organs. then what is the functions? These are the different functions helpful for the motility and fertility, then acidity of the vagina, contraction of uterus, and its support to the spoon. So this is the detail about the semen. Now next one, what is the different parts of the female reproductive system? It is divided into external and internal genital organs. So external organs containing different parts, 7 different parts, whereas internal organs containing, these all are the organs present in the external and internal types of the female reproductive system. Now next, see, these are the external parts. You should pause this video and write in your notebook for better understanding. Next part is external. After external is internal. These are the different parts of the internal organs containing vagina, uterus, fallopian tube and ovaries. These parts khub mahatvache ahet he vicharle jatat exam. So the next part is the functions of uterus and functions of fallopian tube. So first one is uterus as a part of the sperms. Then second one is the implantation of fertilized ovum. Then the development of fetus. These are the different functions of the uterus. Whereas what about the function of fallopian tubes? It is provide the sperm from the uterus to the ovum or the ovary. It's also helpful for the secretion of the different parts or the nutrition of ovum. It is also useful for the site of the fertilization. So this is the different functions of the uterus and fallopian tubes. ये दोनों questions exam में भी चल रहे हैं. So all of you should write in your notebook. Now the next part is what is menstrual cycle? Very important. This is the series of events occurring regularly in the female's ovary every 26 to 30 days throughout the childbearing age. So what are the changes occurring? There are the different phases containing 28 days the cycle. Menstrual cycle or menstrual phase is 4 days, then proliferative phase is 10 days and secretory phase is 14 days. So this is the detail about the menstrual cycle. Exam mode definition lihu shakta hai, ha circle draw karu shakta hai ani phases kontya kontya hai cycle che tahi tumhi lihu shakta. Now what happen exactly? There is a changes occurring in the endometrium of the non-pregnant female, and due to this reason there is a chances of the bleeding or the chances of the breaking of the some layers of the some capillaries which is present in the uterus, and that may be falls in the blood. So what are the different steps? These are the three different stages of the menstrual cycles. This is the detail about the menstrual phase, proliferative phase and secretory phase. It just depends on the four parts. First one is the follicle stimulating hormone. Second one is the luteinizing hormone. Then the two sex hormones which is released by the females, that is estrogen and progesterone. This menstrual cycle is depend on these four factors. So all of you should write this all in your notebook, and which is helpful for the exam point of view. Exam mode barach bada vicharlela aahe. Now what happens if you see this graph containing the FSH and LH? FSH follicle stimulating hormone, LH is luteinizing hormone. See the level of graph. What happens against the dates, and what happens, these are the ovarian hormones, that is the estrogen and progesterone. If you see from left to right, there is a formation of eggs, and that eggs containing ovulation, and after development of corpus luteum, it is returned to the next cycle. So this is the changes occurring like this. See here, these are the changes happens in the structures. Now what is the next? What changes occurring in the puberty? So what is puberty first? Puberty is the age at which the internal reproductive organs reaches the maturity. Kishor vayan mhanta means the age between the 10 to 14, 10 ते 14 वयाच्या गटामध्ये, this called as the puberty age. What happens? Luteinizing hormones from the anterior lobe of the pituitary glands मधून काय होत असते? Production होत असते some sex hormones along with the female sex hormones. मेल मध्ये टेस्टिस दॅट रिलीज द टेस्टोस्टेरॉन, फीमेल मध्ये ओव्हरीज दॅट रिलीज द प्रोजेस्टेरॉन अँड एस्ट्रोजन्स. सो व्हॉट चेंजेस ऑकरिंग ड्यूरिंग द प्युबर्टी? व्हॉट हॅपन इन फीमेल? दीज आर द व्हाईट लाईन्स, ऑल ऑफ यू रीड दॅट ऑल व्हाईट पॉइंट्स. रीच इन द मॅच्युरिटी, मेन्स्ट्रुअल सायकल स्टार्ट होत आहे, ओव्ह्युलेशन बिगेन्स होत आहे, बॉडीमध्ये शेप चेंज होत असतो, ब्रेस्ट डेव्हलप एन्लार्जमेंट होत असतात, देन हेअर्स बिगेन्स होत असतात, हाईट वेट वाढत असते, इन्क्रीज द फॅट. दीज आर द डिफरंट चेंजेस ऑकरिंग ड्युरिंग द प्युबर्टी एज. व्हॉट हॅपन इन फिमेल, ग्रोथ ऑफ मसल्स, देन व्हॉइस चेंजेस, हेअर ग्रोथ ऑन द फेस, देन चेंज द साईज इन द पेनिस, सॅक्रोडोम अँड प्रोस्टेट ग्लँड्स, अँड प्रोडक्शन ऑफ स्पर्मॅटोजोआन्स. दीज आर द डिफरंट पार्ट्स एक्झाममध्ये विचारतायत. दोन्हीमधला एक तर फिक्स क्वेश्चन असतो, मेल किंवा फिमेलमध्ये कोणते चेंजेस होत असतात. So now the next part is, this is the structure of the testis, this is the TS structure of testis. All of you should know the cells which is present in the structure of testis, which is very important for the production of the sperm. Primary spermatocytes, secondary spermatocytes, then fertile cells, Leydig cells, these are the important for the release or the formation of the semen or the fluids which is present in the testis. Now the structure of ovaries containing 2 in number, there is a presence of different layers containing cortex, some follicles is also present, corpus luteum is also present, and another point is the medulla is also present. So this is the structure of ovary. Now next, if you see, this is the one diagram of the structure of kidney, what happened from day 1 to day 28. If you see the series of changes occurring, the structure of the egg or the fertile cells, that is pyramidal cells and the ovarian cells, changes occurring, and there's at the day of 14 there is ovulation takes place, and after the formation of corpus luteum it back to the cell. So what is the functions? These are the different functions of the ovaries. And then what are the different disorders of the male and female reproductive system? Number one is menopause, or some terminologies which is important for the exam point of view. What is menopause? It is just opposite to the puberty. What happens is here, at the age of 45 to 55 years, especially in female, is a loss of childbearing capacity, or at the end of the childbearing period known as menopause. These are the some changes occurring during the menopause. What is infertility? Inability of the male to reproduce or animal to reproduce. The placenta, very important structure of placenta, which is present in between the fetus and the mother, which carries the nutritive material to the fetus for the growth of the different organs by oxygenated blood. So this is the detail about the reproductive system. I hope all of you understand well. If any doubt, you can contact me. My mail address, my phone number is there. You can subscribe my YouTube channel. If not subscribed till now, just subscribe. Thank you so much for the patience listening. Thank you once again.